Hey guys, in this video, we're going to take a look at the Beelink SEi13 Pro with an Intel 13900HK and 32 gigs of LPDDR5 RAM running at 6,000 megatransfers per second. Now, a quick disclaimer here is that Beelink did reach out and send me this device. That said, they get no say in my review and no money changed hands. They'll see this review when you do. The unboxing experience was pretty straightforward. In the box, you get the SEi13 Pro, a welcome card, a user manual, and an HDMI cable, as well as a power cable that is 19 volts at 5.26 amps. Looking around the device, the case appears to be made of aluminum, but there's not really much else going on other than some branding across the top. On the front of the SEi13 Pro, there's a 4-microphone array, a power button, a CMOS reset button, a 3.5mm combo audio jack, and two USB 3.2 ports. One of them is USB-C, and the other is USB-A. On the back, there are two more USB 3.2 Type-A ports, a 2.5GB LAN port, a DisplayPort 1.4 port, a USB 2.0 Type-A port, an HDMI 2 or 2.1 port, it's not really disclosed on their website, another 3.5mm combo audio jack, a USB-C port that supports data and video, and a barrel jack for power. And on the bottom, there are a lot of ventilation holes to draw cool air in from the bottom to exhaust out the top of the back. When we remove that bottom plate, we'll see there's a fine metal mesh filter that has two speakers in it that are barely wider than my finger that sound pretty good as long as you place the SEi13 Pro on the right surface. And if we take off that mesh filter plate and turn it over, we'll see the DSP or digital signal processor and amplifier that power those little speakers. So quick side note here, the speakers, like I mentioned a second ago, sound really good for being as small as they are. And while they're not room shaking, they get loud enough for an office or a bedroom and didn't distort even when I was playing some pretty bass heavy music. Switching over to the inside of the PC, we'll see a heat sink that cools the NVMe drives. Now this unit came with a single 1 terabyte Crucial drive, but there is another NVMe slot for more storage, and both slots run at PCIe 4x4. Now below that empty NVMe slot is an Intel AX200 NGW Wi-Fi and Bluetooth card that supports Wi-Fi 6 and Bluetooth 5.2. Now, something that I noticed while I was doing the basic teardown of this device is that the RAM is soldered. I confirmed that with Beelink, so there's no way to upgrade the RAM beyond what it comes with from the factory. So with the teardown done, let's talk a little bit about the setup process and what it's like to use the SEi13 Pro from Beelink. Once I plugged in the HDMI, the network, the keyboard, the power, I noticed that the keyboard lit up immediately despite the device not being powered on. When I did some more testing, it seems as though even with the device off, it draws about 4 watts from the wall. Again, that's 4 watts with the device off. So there are some actively powered USB ports that I guess you could use for charging even if the device is off. But it is something that I wanted you to be aware of. So at this point, I powered on the device and jumped into the UEFI, and it all looked pretty standard. But something I noticed is that there's an overclocking section in the UEFI. Also, the 13900HK is an unlocked chip, so this should be overclockable, but with its current configuration, it isn't. When I brought this up to Beelink, they told me that the 13900HK was chosen more for its performance per watt efficiency rather than its overclocking potential. And something else that I noticed that they had done here, and they actually mentioned in their email, is that the 13900HK in this device is limited to a 65 watt TDP, which is great because it shouldn't overheat too much, but there seems to be a lot of extra kind of performance left on the table due to the limitations of both the power being limited as well as the small form factor cooling of devices like this. So once I was done poking around in the UEFI, I decided to go ahead and jump into Windows, but then I realized, oh yeah, I've got to set up Windows 11 Pro, and I didn't want to go through that process. So I just used one of the bypass the Windows setup process trick things and was on my desktop in just a few minutes. At which point I immediately ran a speed test and was able to saturate that 2.5GB Ethernet port without any issues whatsoever. That's no updates, that's no driver changes, just straight out of the box was able to saturate that 2.5GB connection. So I was real happy with that. Then, just for funsies, I downloaded Furmark and HWInfo and ran a Furmark test at 1080p using Vulkan and got about 20 to 21 FPS. The CPU at this point peaked at about 5.4 gigahertz, which is great. And the CPU, though, did hit 87 degrees Celsius and did manage to thermal throttle just a little bit by only hitting 54 watts to the CPU. So that's just some information for you there. The other thing that I wanted to mention here is that while the CPU did throttle a little bit, the likelihood of you actually running your system at like synthetic loads all of the time, pretty slim. So again, this was just to see what would happen in the worst case scenario during other usage. Actually went pretty good. So let's talk about that for a minute. So this is the point where I'm supposed to talk about daily tasks, like watching YouTube and doing stuff online and that sort of thing. This is a beast of a machine with a lot of RAM. So it's going to handle your daily tasks without any issue. So I wanted to get that out of the way. I don't want to waste your time any more than I am right now. It's going to handle daily tasks like a beast, no issues there. Now, that said, I did manage to do a little bit of gaming on the SEi 13 Pro, and while it won't handle AAA titles, I was able to play some eSports like Fortnite and Rocket League. So I'm not an eSports player, but I did try a couple of them just to see how it would go. In Fortnite, like I said, I've got no idea what I'm doing, so I just ran around a bunch and managed to level up a couple of times by doing that. And so then I decided to move on to Rocket League. And again, very little idea what I was doing, but I did manage to score 2 goals and win a match, so that's something. I will say that both titles felt really smooth. I never noticed any stuttering or hiccups while I was playing, so that means my really bad playing was a result of me and definitely not the device. Basically, what I'm getting at here is that if you attached a webcam and your standard peripherals to this, you'd have a pretty solid machine for browsing the internet, doing your online tasks, a little eSports gaming, and maybe a little bit of light video editing, as long as you don't mind waiting for the export. Also, just an interesting point of reference, earlier in the video, I mentioned that there is a 4-microphone array on the front of this device, and this little clip is recorded on that microphone array.
So I think for a lot of people, the Beelink SEi 13 Pro would make a great desktop replacement. And that said, it would also make a really great home server. Now look, it's not going to idle at like 3 watts, but it's also not going to take up a lot of space on your shelf, and it's got enough CPU cores and RAM to run several LXCs or a couple of larger VMs without any issue. And with the Intel iGPU, you could pass that through to a VM and use it to transcode multiple video streams on Plex or Jellyfin or whatever your favorite self-hosted media server is. Now that said, a while back we did a live stream where we tested an Ollama AI VM on an iGPU, and it didn't go well, so maybe limit your expectations if you try to use it in an AI environment. So whether you're looking for a solid desktop machine for daily use or some content creation, or even a little bit of eSports gaming, or you're looking for a small home server to host your favorite self-hosted services, the SEi 13 Pro from Beelink is a pretty solid contender. And I say that if you can overlook the soldered RAM, the single 2.5 gig Ethernet port, and the $539 price tag when it's on sale. So let me know what your thoughts are in the comment section down below. I want to thank Beelink for sending this over for me to take a look at. And I want to thank you guys for spending a few minutes of your day with me here today. And with that said, I'm going to go ahead and wrap this up, and I'll talk to you in the next video.